Dialysis. In this dialysis bag there is mixture of glucose, sodium chloride and starch. The membrane, dialysis membrane, is surrounded by water. I have collected outside water at 15 minutes, at 30 minutes. Now we're gonna collect the content of the dialysis bag. Okay, and now that we have enough materials for analysis, I'm gonna do tests for chloride ions, for starch, and for glucose. So, at 15 minutes, this is our sample. We're gonna put some of the sample in wells for iodine test, for chloride test, and here in the test tube for glucose analysis. Okay, now sample at 30 minutes. Again, part goes for iodine test, for chloride test, and here some for glucose test at 30 minutes. The bag, content of the bag, would be analyzed the same way. Iodine test, bag content, chloride test, bag content, and bag content analysis for glucose. This is how the positive test result looks like. Test for chloride is done with silver nitrate and turns white. Test for glucose is with Benedict's reagent. After heating, it turns red, and test for starch is a black purple color with the iodine reagent. Now let's start with our chloride test. These are our samples. And we're gonna add silver nitrate, sample like 15 minutes outside water, 30 minutes outside water, and the bag content. Okay, if we see closer, take a closer look, then we'll see that there is some chloride. Are some chloride ions at 15 minutes, there are more at 30 minutes since it's more white, and the bag, the content of the bag also contains chloride ions. They come from sodium chloride. So sodium chloride can go outside of the dialysis bag even at 15 minutes, more at 30 minutes, and of course some remains in the bag. Let's see now our iodine test. For starch. Okay, this is the iodine reagent. Outside water at 15 minutes, outside water at 30 minutes, content of the dialysis bag. We can clearly see the difference. positive test for iodine was black, purple, and so positive test for starch was with iodine and turned black, purple. This is the positive, the color of the positive test. So apparently starch stays only in the bag, because at 15 minutes, at 30 minutes, there is no starch in the outside water. And finally, the test for glucose. We're gonna add 10 drops of Benedict's reagent and heat the test. And now the test tubes go to warm boiling water bath. Okay, the results from the test. Well, there is certainly glucose inside the bag. At 30 minutes, there is some glucose in the outside water, because we see this white, very slight reddish tint. At 15 minutes, this time is not enough for enough glucose to exit the bag, so no color developed, because it's not enough time. So more glucose is visible at 30 minutes, and as the dialysis goes longer, more glucose will exit the dialysis bag.